Hello, I'm a curator, a lecturer in metallurgy. I'm a scientist. And I preach Christianity, Sikhism, and real Islam. And it is so easy. If you go by logical reasoning brews logo, and logo is his word, and that is bring you the understanding of the subject of religion. That we have one God. If we have one God, there should be one faith, not two faith. If there are two God, there will be two faith. Three God, three faith. So if you believe that we have one God, that is one faith. So why people are talking about interfaith? There is no interfaith. In Christianity, there are people are blind, spiritually blind. There are 400 cults, you know, in Christianity. And I attended one of their conference in London, and I told them, you are like blind man defining an elephant. When I call them blind man, they did not like it. They say, we are happy to be blind. If you are not blind, then you will see one elephant. The whole elephant, one God, one faith. So, God, the knowledge of religion in this dark age, when the books are corrupt and useless, full of dust lying on them, and these dog-collared priests working for mammon, they are spiritually dead, then you have to find the truth yourself, and then you start thinking. Sorry. Then you start thinking logically, and you will get logo, and logo is his word, which is called revelation. So, gospel is revelation on individual basis. Whoever does the logical reasoning, he will get logo. Not everybody else. Others can read Bible day and night, they will get nothing. Bible is forbidden in the royal kingdom of God. That's why Jesus said, when you go to work or become an apostle, don't take any money in your pocket. No true shoe, no true tunic, and no script. Script means Bible is forbidden. They have changed the script to sacks. Sacks mean to carry on your shoulder here. What a nonsense. So, the royal kingdom of God is above the below. Below is the word, secular word, where the scripture dominates, book. And they are called milk. And we are on meat. So, this is the relationship between the two. This is John the Baptist. He was an ideal rabbi. Matthew 13 verse 52. Prophet Elijah. So he was the cornerstone of the temple. And he was ousted out by the hypocrite temple priest. They put on silken clothes and very nice big hat. Very impressive. So they became the cornerstone of the temple. That's why Jesus said the builders are sons of man who rejected the stone. It has become the cornerstone of the temple. So people who reject those priests, they being hypocrite and deliver sugar-coated sermon, they became the chief priest over there. And they killed Christ Jesus. So they could have killed John the Baptist, but he went to the wilderness. There was one Zechariah who was killed in the temple. So This is the narrow gate to the royal kingdom of God here, which is above. This is our sadhu, Vaishyadik. Sadhus, they don't take money. They have left the worldly kingdoms. They have left the world, they go to the wilderness. Over there they ponder over His word to be united with Him. And when they preach gospel, they preach it from their mouth, and they don't open a book to read what is written here and there. Reading and here, finish it here. John the Baptist, Luke 16, verse 16. Law and prophets were till John the Baptist. So after that one, this narrow gate is opened by Christ Jesus, and there we enter this royal kingdom where we have the soul is concerned, not your physical body. Among the sadhus, if you ask them, what is your tribe? And they will tell you, we became sadhus. Our tribe doesn't exist. It exists, you know. But it is, over there, it is extrinsic. The spiritual self, soul is extrinsic, and the tribal identity is intrinsic, is hidden. As you have a seed of wheat, if you plant it in the soil, the seed itself can't bear fruit. It has to be destroyed or planted, the identity of the seed. When it is seed, you can see it is explicit, its identity. So here, the identity of the seed is explicit. You can see it, that this man belongs to Judah tribe, Benjamin tribe, Levi tribe, so and so. But when you sow it, then it turns into plant. And that plant is called twice born. It will bear fruit. Once born people don't bear fruit. So then it can find this narrow gate and enter this royal kingdom of God, where we have laborers, workers, working in the royal vineyard of our supernatural Father. Here, because it's above of sadhus, or celestial world of sadhus. So here the money does not count. Here your devotion count. Your faith, as Saul was, you know, it was his faith that counted. And then his eyes was opened by Christ Jesus. So here the teachers, they have the scripture. Teachers can make you spiritually blind as you go to the universities and colleges. Those people studying over there, the theology, their teacher teach the dead letters of the Old and the New Testament, make you super donkey carrying holy books. They have no idea of the spiritual self. Without Bible, they can't utter a single word from their mouth. They must look into the Bible. When you become Christ, spiritual, then you burn your ego in this over here, this kiln here, which Moses burning bush. And when you burn it, your ego, then it is turned into plant. As when you put a wheat plant in this wheat seed in the soil, when the plant appears, the seed disappears, and the identity of the seed becomes implicit, not explicit anymore. So here you have your identity in soul becomes explicit, your identity in seed becomes implicit. Here you have your own mother and father, and here we have one father of our soul, Elohim Allah Pabram. We are all sons of the Most High. No daughter here. because son represents father. In flesh, you could be a female. And here, when you become twice born, you become a male. Whether you are in flesh, male or female, Jew or Gentile, all equal here. Sons are the Most High. So here we are the sons of the Most High, and these are the people that is capable of being fished into the royal kingdom of God, twice more, not the once more people. Once more people, they do not know our supernatural Father. They have buried the ego of their seed. They display ego once more, so they can't enter this narrow gate. So, this is the above, where from Christ Jesus came, and this is below. So all these things I have drawn myself. So once you get small iota of His word, then you should ponder over it and write it down on a piece of paper, then start making a YouTube video, and God will give you more understanding. You will get expanding the thing. So, here is the relationship between John the Baptist and Christ Jesus. John the Baptist is here, moon, a witness to the light, but not the light, moon. So here we have prophets and angels, all right? And here we are all sons of the Most High. We are saints. No prophet or angel here. Prophet and angel here. In fact, when the Jesus turned the product of these rabbis, the tribal peoples, salt of the earth, into the son of the supernatural Father, Elohim Allah Pabram. Then this man who has made them the sons of the man, he is very happy to see that his product have been uplifted to become a saint. So he will sing praises when the bridegroom marries the Virgin Bride. So here is something I have written, and it will make clear what I am going to talk and what is the we talk about this revelations. Holy Gospel of our Supernatural Father Elohim Allah Pabram, same thing, etc. Delivered by the first anointed Christ, which in Punjabi, my native language, we call Satguru Jesus, of the highest living God, Elohim Allah Pabram, our supernatural Father, that dwells in His most beautiful temple of God. This is the temple of God, most beautiful in the world. Lily of the field is better dressed than King Solomon in his best attire. Our physical body, created not by the human hands, but by the demiurge potter, the Lord of the nature, Yahweh, Brahma, Khuda, etc. This is creation of Yahweh, Brahma, Khuda, represented by angel John the Baptist, prophet, last prophet. His religion is to worship God, which is the creation of this, which is Yahweh Brahma Kada. Jesus came to worship our supernatural Father, which is above the natural Father. And so He is greater than these rabbis. They are written here, the law and prophets finished by John the Baptist, Luke 16 verse 16. at the time of clearing up the wheat seed, the tribal sons of man, from the threshing floor of the rabbis, sons of man, began with Christ Jesus. So what was the duty of those rabbis was to make people of their tribal fathers, sons of their tribal fathers. And he worshipped Yahweh. Yahweh is the demiurge, creator of male and female. So did St. Thomas. You know, St. Thomas went to India, South India, where there was a heap of wheat seed, the sons of man over there, you know, in the South India. The name of the boy contained four elements. One is his first name, then his father's name, Ben so and so, father's name, and then his village where he was born, a place of birth, and then his surname. By these four things he is fully identified. And they were the one who was the salt of the earth. No crime over there in South India, as in North India where I come from. So people are very docile. And over there, you know, the people were salt of the earth. And over there, then St. Thomas went there to sow the seed of his word in their heart. And over there, those people who had the seed sown in their heart, or the gospel written over their hearts, they could preach gospel without looking at any book. So they were twice more laborers of St. Thomas, son Saint. And this Portuguese Pope went there. He said, oh, there's only one Christ. You can't call yourself Christ. And they were murdering, killing them. So they run to the mountain. They used to be prosperous businessmen. So they have to leave their businesses and run to mountain for protection. So St. Thomas went to the South India, where there was a heap of wheat seeds, because they had their tribal identity explicit, you know, by four names, clearly defined whose son he is and where he lives. Wheat seeds, the sons of man. Wheat plants are the tribal people found in Russia, Afghanistan, Balochistan, etc., Kazakhstan, East, that is East India side, and Middle East, where the Jerusalem temple is, are this one. So over there people had their tribal identity intact. At the Brazilian and African jungles that have the tribal marks over their faces. I myself, you know, I was a lecturer at University of Science and Technology, Kumasi. Over there people have tribal marks on their faces. By looking at the face of a person, you can tell which tribe he come from. And they were living in peace, because this planet Earth is for the habitation of the sons of man. 144,000 that will live, survive the atomic war. They are all mentioned by their tribes and not as Jews. So this planet Earth for the habitation of the tribal people, and not for Jew, Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Christian, etc. They will kill each other, as they are doing in Afghanistan, in like Jerusalem. So, Brazilian jungles, African jungles, sorry, that have the tribal marks over their faces. Abraham gave the tribal mark to circumcision to Isaac. The circumcision is the tribal mark of Abraham to Isaac. His real son, he was real son, not to Ishmael, born of a concubine, Hagar. Thus, Yeshua, Yah from Yahweh, and Shiva, or Shiva means the primal Adam. So Jesus was the first born of Yahweh, the second Adam. Yahweh and Shiva is the primordial Adam. We call it Shiva in Punjabi. Was supposed to be coming among the most clever people of the Judah tribe. So Jesus came among the people which were very clever. So to cure them, they were spiritually sick, he came to cure them, but they loved darkness and they killed him around. Oh dear. Abraham gave the tribal mark of circumcision to Isaac, his real son, and not to Ishmael, born of a concubine. Concubine Hagar. Thus, Yeshua, Yah from Yahweh, Shua or Shiva means the primordial Adam, was supposed to be coming among the most clever people of the Judah tribe, had the circumcision, and a woman admired Jesus, you know, when he was doing merciful deed. That is, you are the real son of real son of King David. King David was a nice person. He was hospitable. Which is called Salt of David. While most of the others of the Judah tribe were greedy or hypocrites that loved darkness. So people of Judah tribe were the one who were most greedy people, and they love darkness so they can carry on the cheating business. They love darkness. A leper also reminded Jesus of his virtual forefather, King David. So they knew that the Messiah will come in line of King David. And so they were, this leper was calling Jesus son of David. And that is why he was calling him, because he was supposed to come in that tribal people. And darkness, the clever people of the Judah tribe had the circumcision, and very greedy, and they were greedy or hypocrites. Hypocrites that loved darkness. Hypocrites, they love darkness, so they can keep on cheating people.
ਜਿਹੜੇ ਬੈਠੇ ਬੈਠੇ ਦੋ ਮਿੰਟਾਂ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਇਹਨੂੰ ਤੋੜ ਭੰਨ ਕੇ ਦੋ ਮਿੰਟਾਂ ਦੇ ਅੰਦਰ ਉਹ ਕੀਤਾ ਇਹਨੂੰ ਤੋੜ ਕੇ ਮੂੰਹ ਨਾਲ ਇੰਨਾ ਕੁਛ ਇੰਨਾ ਤੋੜ ਦਿੱਤਾ
Oh. Oh, Anya come. Nice Anya. Good girl.
Yeah.
Have biscuit here.
Anyway, I don't think he will do anything. ਉਹ ਗਲੇ ਦਾ ਸਿਰਾ ਵੀ ਜੇ ਗਲਾ ਦੇਖ ਦਿੰਦੇ ਵੀ ਗਲਾ ਠੀਕ ਹੈ ਰੱਖ ਲਈ ਕਿਉਂਕਿ ਗਲੇ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਵੀ ਖੱਖਰੀ ਲੱਗੀ ਰਹਿੰਦੀ ਹੈਗੀ ਮੈਂ ਸੋਚਦੀ ਸੀ ਉਹ ਪਾਸ ਕਰਕੇ ਹੈਗਾ ਹੁਣ ਬਈ ਪਾਸ ਵੀ ਲਈ ਜਾਵਾਂ ਕਿ ਕੀ ਕਰਾਂ ਬੇਬੀ
So it was a John the Baptist. He was the last prophet in the promised land. So these rabbis, they produced a heap of the wheat plant, wheat grains, a wheat seed. Their duty was to produce sons of man, which they produced. So the floor heap, threshing floor of the rabbis, it was full. So Jesus came to clear it up, to turn the seed, the sons of man, into the sons of our supernatural Father God. That is what his role was in Christianity. To clear the threshing floor of the rabbis. So both rabbis and Christ Jesus, they were very happy to see it. By coming, thus Yeshua, Yeh from Yahweh and Shua Ashiva Mini from Mulia Adam, was forced to be coming among the most clever people of the Judah tribe, had the circumcision, and a woman admired him as the sort of King David, whilst most of the others of the Judah tribe were greedy or hypocrites, crooks that loved darkness. A leper also reminded Jesus of his spiritual forefather, King David. Jesus was not the son of King David because he was born of a virgin. But he was to appear among the people of Judah tribe, and he healed him. This is the time of the Holy Spirit, which is common sense, or Surti. In Hindi we call it Surti. No corruptible, dead letters, old cloth, full of the holes of corruption, but wind, you know, wind which we call pavan. Remember in Nicodemus, Jesus said, the wind blows, you don't know where from it comes, of its own pleasure or by the grace. So they say in our Punjabi, this age is called Pavan Arambh. Pavan means the wind, is the era of the wind, not of the dead books. Pavan Arambh Satgur Matvila. Satgur means the one who has the formula of finding the Sat, the absolute truth, which is logical reasoning. So Matvila means the Mat means the wisdom, akal.
Maybe where are you? Huh?
Oh, oh. Go to grandma. So Satguru Matvila, his word, Oral Torah, time, Shabd, his word, Logo, is your guru or teacher. Surt means common sense. Holy Spirit, Dhun, Chela, admiring disciple. Don't mean that when you are, you know, very much engaged in listening to what the word is coming out, then you call it's very bone. Something Jesus advised his workers. Workers, they were Sikh, no, they were known as Tarkhan. Apostles, do not take money in your pocket. No two shoes, no two tunics, two dresses, you know. Up like the temple priests. They were having nice whitewashed clothes and other things. Too many dresses that in their wardrobes. To dress up like the temple priests. You see these Russian priests, you know how they are, how many tunics they have, you know. And no script, the Jewish level, the dead letters, the Bible, as our covenant with Jesus is of the Holy Spirit, which is common sense. And that of the dead letters finished with John the Baptist. So putting the Bible in the hands of Jesus and his workers, the saints, like St. Paul especially, the apostles, is Antichrist. That's St. Paul said, you know, why his word cannot be written down in ink on paper, but over the living tablet of heart, and you put Bible in his hands, he's making him Antichrist. And so are those idols against which St. Paul spoke, and he was beaten hard. So he was beaten so hard, you know, that he had to end up in the jail. when he sang the praises of our supernatural father in jail, and those who lent their ears, and they were set free. And that is the gospel. So I hope you enjoy it. Sorry for this silence, you know. And this is very interesting.